Good morning. Here in this place, Jesus is here. Welcome to Super Sunday. What makes it super is, again, that Jesus is here. You proclaim that. You live that. You are a light for others. We need a lot of light. You heard. Be signed with me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May grace and peace of our God, who still creates, may the love of Jesus, who is saving, may the Holy Spirit be with you now. Let us pause and think about our lives. That you would take away all depression. Lord, have mercy. That you would grace us to give hope to others. Christ, have mercy. That you would bring healing to those who have been ill. Lord, have mercy. O Almighty One, forgive, understand, and bring the people to life everlasting. Amen. O come, let us worship our God. Let us bow before the one who has made us, Lord God. Keep your family safe from with unfailing care that relying solely on your hope, your heavenly grace, that all would be defended by your protection. We pray this in the Lord, who lives and reigns in unity with the Holy Spirit. You are one forever and ever.
Amen.
Proclamation from the book of Job. Job spoke to his friends. Does not the human being have a hard service on earth, and are not their days like the days of a laborer? Like a slave who longs for the shadow, and like a laborer who longs for their wages, so I am allotted months of emptiness, and nights of misery are apportioned to me. When I lie down, I say, when shall I rise? But the night is long, and I am full of tossing until dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle, and come to their end without hope. Remember that my life is a breath. My eye will never again see good. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A proclamation from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. My sisters and brothers, if I proclaim the gospel, this gives me no ground for boasting, for an obligation is laid on me. And woe to me if I do not proclaim the gospel. For if I do this of my own will, I have a reward. But if not of my own will, I am entrusted with a commission. So what then is my reward? Just this, that in my proclamation I may make the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my rights in the gospel. For though I am free with respect to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so that I might win more of them. To the weak, I became weak, so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, so that I may share in its blessings. The word of the Lord.
Is with you. This is the good news according to Mark. On leaving the synagogue, it was Jesus who entered the house of Simon and Andrew, along with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law was sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached
He grasped her by the hand. He helped her up. The fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening, after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town gathered at the door, curing many who were sick with various diseases. He drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak, because they knew him. And rising very early before dawn, he left. He went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him. Finding him, they said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go to the nearby villages, that I may preach there also. For this purpose I have come." And so he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons through the whole of Galilee, the gospel of the Lord.
I got a call this morning about 7:15, and it was our deacon, Sandy, said, "Can you do me a favor? I'm supposed to be with you, but the Capuchins, both about 85 years of age, were finding it difficult to get to Good Shepherd." And so he was going to have to do both of the services there this morning, and mostly just proclaim readings and distribute communion. I said, "No, I'm ready to go." I'm always looking at those readings because I need to first apply them to my life. Job shares with us, with his friends, he says, how very low he is and how depressed he is. He's lost his children. He's lost his farm. He's lost all the animals. Everything that was his, that he had accomplished, was gone and taken from him. Depressed, he cannot sleep. Night drags on, he gets up, so he says. Job never totally let go of his hope. Each of us have known circumstances in our own existence. We struggle with them, and then a new day comes. I had the occasion one time to be on the pier fishing, and not the regular walkout pier, one you have in the middle by the main gap, leaving Milwaukee. We're perch fishing. My buddy was way over on one end, and I was way over on the other, and it was early in the morning. And the pier there slants down. I was wearing tennis shoes. I thought it was fine. Took the first step, and it was slime, and I went down. Rod went down. I'm holding on, sliding, looking at my friend who's beyond yelling at to hear me, and holding on for dear life. The water's very cold. And after hanging there for 10 minutes and seeing my whole life go before me, he came over laughing, extended the landing net to me, and I managed to get back up. I did that once before with a car. I parked early in the morning at the side of the road, and the shoulder wasn't very big, and the sun was so bright that when I pulled to the shoulder and got out of the car tipped. I remember these things. I remember the farmer half a mile down the road who came over with the tractor and pulled my car back. Saint Paul tells us, he's compelled to announce the good news of Jesus. And he has found a way to relate to the people that he deals with. Now, he was a lawyer and he was well-educated, but he said, with the lowly and the poor, I became poor. When it was convenient, or whether it was inconvenient, I did it. Because it has to be shared. Jesus set up his headquarters at Capernaum. That was the synagogue that he went to. He was no longer Jesus of Nazareth. He was Jesus of Capernaum. He gets up in the middle of the night. For what reason? To get away from the crowd. For solitude and prayer, that he might reflect and recreate and restore energies. And they come to him, his followers now. I say, Lord, they want more of you here. And what does he say? No, we just can't stay here. We got to go on to the nearby villages and towns. They have to hear the good news. The same commission, I'm telling you, is given to you to announce your faith and good news. Whether it's to Menomonee Falls or to Sussex, to Lisbon, to Lannan, to Butler, to Pewaukee, to Waukesha. I know John's from Waukesha. Wherever we are, I have been saved. I have been redeemed. God's presence, God's love has brought healing to me and continues to do so. That they may see by not your only by your words, but by your example of how you recognize that too. You are the evangelizers. I was asked to give a warning to you, or an admonition or concern, and I think it's just common sense. We're in the flu season, so if somebody doesn't grab your hand at the sign of peace, it's okay, huh, for a while. Maybe they're contagious. We want to share the good things, not the bad. If you don't feel comfortable and you're communicative, oh, all this antibiotic and sterile, don't take from the cup. Use common sense. Kind of like this mood lighting we have here. But I would say to those whose nights are long and who struggle with loss or fear or worry, have hope. The morning comes. Today is a new day. I have been saved. I have been rescued. To God we give the praise. Amen.
Amen.
For I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified and died in his burial. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead.
Lord, so much in common we have. Hear the prayers of the faithful.
Our response, Lord, hear our prayer. The middle schoolers from all local parishes are on retreat this weekend at St. James. We pray for them, their catechists, their parents, and teachers, that they may come to form closer relationships with God. For the youth in our church, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the nations. May the demons in society be identified and cast out, bringing a worldwide reign of justice. For peace on our earth, we pray. Like Job, for many, life is a drudgery filled with hopelessness. Inspire and motivate those who have the power to change the lives of the powerless by providing for their basic needs and treating them with respect. For the poor, the outcast, and marginalized, we pray.
Lord.
We pray for the sick and the suffering and all who struggle in life. May we be willing to go with them like Christ did, and bringing compassion and healing powers with us. We pray. For those signed in our Book of Life, for Elizabeth Bauer, who recently died, and especially Jeanette Tolfa and Joe Baim, for whom this Eucharist is offered, we pray.
Lord, Lord, many are our requests. Help us. Help us to be positive and bring healing by what we say and what we do. Grant this in our communion with you now and forever.
Amen. Our presentation song is found on page 25, God of Second Chances.
Pray with me. What then is offered, may this be acceptable by our God. Lord, God, you established the created things to sustain us in our own frailty. We pray that we might become for that these become for us now the sacrament of life eternal. Grant this in the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And
with your spirit. O lift your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Together then we would give thanks to the Lord who is God of all. Right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, to the Almighty and the Eternal. Out of compassion for the waywardness that sometimes is ours, humbling himself, born of the Virgin, by passion on a cross he freed us from an unending death, by rising he gave us all eternal life. With the angels, with the thrones, the dominions, the hosts and powers of heaven, we would sing. Give you praise, you God of all. You have fashioned from all of your works and done it in wisdom and love, humankind in your own image. You entrust this world to our care, serving you, the Creator, you might have dominion. When through disobedience we lost your friendship, you did not abandon us to death. You came in mercy and aid to all to seek and find you. Time and again, you offered the covenant. You offered the prophets, teaching us to look forward to our salvation. You loved the world so much in the fullness of time to send Jesus. Incarnate of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, human, like us in everything but sin. Proclaiming good news, freedom, joy to accomplish your plan, giving himself up to death, rising from it, he destroyed it and gave back life to us, that we might live no longer only for ourselves. The Spirit was sent to bring perfection to work in this world, to sanctify all of your creation. May this Spirit sanctify what we now have brought. Let these offerings become the body and blood of Jesus. The hour came, loving his people. At the meal, taking bread and saying, blessing, this too was broken to be shared. Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. Taking the chalice with the fruit of the vine, giving thanks, this too was offered. Take this, all of you, drink from it now. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the everlasting covenant, poured for you, for many. Our sin is forgiven. Do this in memory of me.
Oh.
is the memorial of redemption. We remember Christ's death, his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim resurrection. We proclaim his ascension. We await the Lord's return. This is offered, the body and blood, the acceptable sacrifice. This is salvation for the whole world. Look upon this, Lord, what you provide now for the church in loving kindness. Grant to those who partake, gathered in body by the Holy Spirit, that they may be a living offering, a sign to praise your glory. Remember those for whom we offer this, with our Pope Francis, with our bishops, with the people who serve the needs of our communities, those we join with in the offering this morning, all the people who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember now Jeanette, Joseph, and this Friday, Elizabeth. Their faith was known to you alone. To all of us, that we would enter with them into the heavenly inheritance, there to join Mary, there to join the others, the whole of creation freed from sin and death, to give glory in Christ, who is Lord, through whom you bestow good on our world. Through Christ, with Christ and in Christ, in unity with the Holy Spirit, glory and honor belongs to you, O God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, now and forever.
Peace I wish for you, peace I give as my gift. Look not on fault but faith. Give them all, Lord, peace now and forever.
Amen.
And with you this morning.
Behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, blessed are you, called to the supper of the Lamb. Body, blood of Jesus, bring us to your life forever.
Amen.
get to heaven.
On a day like today, anybody taking communion? Someone who can't get here? You it is who carry the Lord, but you would carry him to the nearby villages, announcing good news, bringing presence and grace of the Almighty. Amen. Thank you.
These are the announcements for this weekend. If you've pre-ordered your Super Bowl party pizzas, don't forget to stop in the community center to pick them up. We've made extras to be sold while supplies last. Thank you for choosing this delicious way to support our mission trippers going to Fremont this summer. Fremont, Nebraska. This weekend is the Super Bowl of caring here at St. James and across the nation. As you leave today, please look for the volunteers holding soup pots and consider a donation to help fight hunger in our community. The donations will benefit our local food pantries in Sussex, Menomonee Falls, and our sister parish, St. Martin de Porres. Are you hoping to grow closer to Christ this Lent? Jesus' invitation to come follow me is just as real today as it was for the first disciples. Consider joining a Catholic ID small group. Stop in the lobby after Mass to find out more. Be sure to stay for fellowship. Enjoy some delicious treats and some time visiting with our fellow parishioners. And a memorial mass for Elizabeth Bauer will be held on Friday at 4 o'clock in the church. Visitation from 2:30 until 4. Please keep Elizabeth's family in your prayers. As always, for more information about our activities here at St. James, check out the bulletin, website, and Facebook.
As we prayed about in our petitions, we have our middle school retreat this weekend, and as Director of Youth Ministry, we have a tremendous honor to be able to present the gospel and present our young people with different kinds of retreats and different ways to experience God so that they may draw closer, they may enter a relationship with Jesus. And so we invited our Spiritus team, Wes from our Spiritus team, who does our 10th grade retreat and has been doing it for the last about 5 years now. And just to tell you a little bit about their organization and how you can help them be a part of the blessing that brings our young people closer to Christ.
Good morning, everyone. So, as Brian said, my name is Wes, and I'm originally from the Great White North of Michigan's Upper Peninsula. So all this snow that we just got is making me feel right at home. And like he said, I wanted to speak to you today about the missionary group that I'm a part of, Spiritus. So Spiritus is a group of 15 young adult missionaries. We're all in between the ages of 21 and 31. And we travel around the state of Wisconsin with one very simple goal in mind: to unite or to ignite the faith in Catholic youth. And our main way of doing that is by putting on retreats. We put on about 150 retreats every year, reaching about 5,000 students all across the state of Wisconsin from the ages of second grade up to seniors in high school. So the students that we work with, we have a very broad range. Now, being on a missionary team, it's very, very rewarding, but it's also very challenging. The 150 retreats that we do, we can't do on our own. And so I'm here today to ask you to consider partnering with the Spiritus mission. And there are three primary ways that you can help support us. The first way is through prayer. You know, as missionaries, we spend about 2 hours every day in prayer. And so it's really the core of what we do. And we would also, since we're in prayer 2 hours every day, I'd like to offer to pray for all of you as well. So in the back, after church, you'll see a table set up with all sorts of Spiritus things that I'll be at. And one of the things that's there is a book of prayer intentions. So, you know, if you want to stop by and say hi afterwards, you can write down anything that you'd like us to take in prayer. We spend about an hour in front of the Blessed Sacrament every day in prayer as well. So I'd be more than happy to bring your prayer intentions to the rest of the team so that we can all pray for you. And please keep us in your prayers as well. The second way that you can help partner with us is to just spread the word about Spiritus. You know, I wouldn't be here had it not been for my aunt in Thiensville, who had a Spiritus team come to her parish, and she told my mom, and my mom told me, and I thought, hey, you know, that sounds great. Menasha's not too far. That's where Spiritus is based. So, you know, why not? We're starting to get into our recruiting season, so if you happen to know any young adults who might be interested in doing something like what we do at Spiritus, let them know about us, because we're looking for missionaries for Team 10 coming up next year. And the third and final way that you can partner with us is through a financial donation. In the back, I also have on our table brochures that have all sorts of information about Spiritus, and in those brochures is a little blue envelope that's already pre-addressed to Spiritus. So if you don't feel called to give today at all, you can take that envelope with you and prayerfully consider donating at a later time and mailing it to us. We also really like food. So something that my teammates and I like to say is that, you know, we accept donations in the form of cash, check, or cheeseburger. So, you know, if you feel like that you don't feel called to donate with a monetary donation, you can also give us a culinary donation. We accept that as well. I also understand that this parish is selling pizzas for the Super Bowl. So if you feel like buying us a pizza, you know, you could kill two birds with one stone. So that's just a little bit about what we do. I am asking again to, you know, prayerfully consider partnering with this mission. Thank you all for your time, and God bless you.
Thank you, Les. Thank you for your witness. So many people involved in bringing good news. We pray. Book. Book. Bell, book, candle. Blessed are those who mourn, they will be consoled. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for what is right, they shall have their fill. You willed that we would be partakers from this bread and chalice, so to live made one in Christ, to joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Grant this in Christ.
Amen.
The Lord is with you. Believe, be blessed, bring blessing, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go from here in peace.
And as we go forth, let us sing, Lead Me, Guide Me, on page 22.